everyone. Welcome to season two of Focus Spender. I have to say season two because it's October and I have not posted a video since July. My life has just been crazy. Thankfully, nothing bad. It's just my job. My job is extremely demanding, and over the summertime, it becomes even more demanding. So literally any free time I had this summer was used to sleep and watch television. Literally, that is it. I didn't go on any vacations. I just came home, lied on my couch, watched television, and went to sleep. Now it's October. Life is feeling a little bit easier, and I have time to do the things that I enjoy outside of work. So that's it. I just wanted to come today and talk to you really quickly about what's been going on with me financially. So first, as of today, I owe Sally Mae $14,686.55. I'm so excited because literally that is my only bill. That is my only straight up debt. I don't have any credit card debt. I don't have any other loans. That's it. And honestly, I wish I could remember how much I owed when I first started doing these videos. I think I was about, $40,000. I'm going to double check. But right now, I only owe $14,686.55. And I hope, I'm really going to try hard to knock that out by the time April 2012 comes. Because after that, I just want to live my life. I just want to use the money that I make to live my life, to go on vacations, to invest, to save, to buy a house, to buy a car, just do the things that I've been putting on hold because I just want that monkey off my back. And that monkey is Sally Mae. Sally Mae is going to be gone in a few months. Mark my words. Another thing that I did, I signed up for the 403B match program at my job. A while ago, I said I wasn't participating in the 403B program because I wanted to use all my extra income to go towards my student loans. But now that I think about that, that was at my previous job when I made that decision where, one, my income was much less. Two, I literally could not afford to participate in that program and pay a significant amount of money towards this. But now that I only have one bill and I make a little bit more money, I can afford it. And I think pre-tax, it's about $50 to $70 every 2 weeks. I don't even remember. So it's not going to break the bank, and it's a match. If you have the opportunity to get a match at your job, always do it. So they match us at 2%, I'm doing 2%. Another thing that I did was sign up for AFLAC, which is disability insurance. I'm gonna talk about why I made that decision in another video, but anything can happen in this world and it can take me out of work. And the disability insurance program at my job, or the previous one, was like nothing. And then I have 2 weeks vacation, and then once that's exhausted, that's it, I have nothing. So I decided, okay, this makes a lot of sense. And for most women, this, like, one thing that some HR managers would tell you about why it's important to sign up for disability, but many won't. And I'm gonna talk about that in a future video. So I decided, let me go ahead and sign up for this AFLAC program. The fourth thing that happened to me this summer was I got into a teeny, teeny, weeny fender bender in my zip car at the airport. The way zip car goes is like you're responsible for a certain portion and then their insurance will kick in after that. So you're responsible for up to $750 in damages. I don't think it was $750 worth of damages, and I'm not gonna take responsibility. I'm not gonna put the responsibility on the other driver, but I had to pay $750 out of my own pocket. And if I wasn't on this financial kick, I didn't have an emergency fund, if I wasn't saving, if I wasn't really, hadn't been wise with my money, this would have broke me. Like, I would have been so stressed. This is the only thing I use my credit card for. Yes, pretty much the only thing. I put all my zip car rentals on my credit card just because it's easy. And I'm actually glad I did because it does come with insurance. I'm not sure if my credit card company is going to pay the $750, as in if they're going to reimburse me, but I decided I'm not going to find out in 5 months that they're not going to reimburse me and be responsible for $750 plus finance charges. So I decided, you have the money, just pay it. So I paid it. And I'm so glad that I am on this financial kick because $750, which is a lot of money, do not get me wrong, it is a lot of money. It's not gonna break me. I'm not gonna not eat. I'm not gonna not pay a bill because of it. I'm not gonna not go out with my friends and do all the things that I still enjoy doing because of it. And I paid it. It's done. If I get a check from my credit card company, great. I will be super excited and I will take that money and I will send it to Sally or I will do something else with it. But for now, that other monkey is off my back. I think that's it in terms of anything financially related going on in my life. One thing that I've noticed now that, all my bills are like running away from me is that I don't have to manage my budget like I used to. I don't have to stare at my computer on mint.com or a spreadsheet every day to see how much I have, how much do you have, how much do you have. And it is very freeing. It's very freeing. I love the feeling. I hope that you guys are seeing in me what you would like to see in yourself, which is how to live not in debt and how good it feels. People always ask me, or not even ask me, they always say, it is so great that you are spending all that money to pay off your student loans, but I just want to live. I don't know how you do it. Guess what? Next year in April, when I'm done, I'll be doing everything they've been doing for the last 3 years, but I'll be able to do this for the rest of my life because I won't have that bill weighing me down. And I'm just super excited, and I hope everyone else is and takes this lesson from me. Just do what you need to do to get out of debt, and you'll be so much happier for it. Talk to you later. Bye.